Inhale with Steve Ross.
Welcome to Inhale. I'm Steve Ross. We're going to do some yoga. Stand up. Bring the feet apart, wide as you like, but at least hip distance apart, and then come forward. You can just hang there, or you can grab the heels or ankles and pull down if you like. Roll the weight toward the balls of the feet. Breathe through the nose. Make sure your neck is soft and relaxed. This hurts your low back. You can bend the knees a little bit. And very slowly, roll all the way up. Step the feet together. Might as well hit it right off the bat, since I'm not doing it. Bring the hands in prayer pose. Inhale the arms up. Drop the head back. Exhale and come forward. Lift the head, inhale, jump or step back. Top of a push-up, just stay there. Make sure when you come down, the elbows are close to the ribs. Also, make sure it takes about 40 seconds to come down. Close enough. Inhale and arch up into the upward facing dog. Arms are straight, legs are straight. You're on the tops of the feet. Pull the shoulders down and back. Head back. Breathe deep through the nose. Next time you exhale, push back into the downward facing dog. Stay here, start to sink the heels down toward the floor. Make sure the arms are straight. You're pushing away hard with the hands. Fingers are spread wide apart. Make sure the palms are flat. Gotta flatten the back like we're doing here. We're also flattening the spirit a little bit. Very lightly, jump or step the feet up to the hands. Roll all the way up, stretch up, arch back. Exhale, come all the way forward. Hands are down, head is up, jump back or step back. Come down. And arch up, upward dog. And push back, down, down. From here, raise the left arm straight up in the air, turn to the side.
Wait a minute.
One-armed incline. If this is too much for you, you can bring the knee down, right knee down. Otherwise, keep the legs straight. Sweet sugar pop, sugar pop, rocks pop. You don't stop till the sweet beat drops. I shall improve as I stick and move. Vivid poems recited on top of the groove. Floating like a butterfly. Set afloat, sung like a lullaby. Brace yourself. From here, come down, do a push-up, do the other side. Keep pushing the hips up high. You can always roll the right shoulder back a little bit.
Funky, funky. Feel the beat drop, jazz and hip-hop.
Yo. Opening your dome, mix its own and bop. A fly illusion keeps you coasting on the rhythm, you're cruising up, down, round, and looks round, good. Bring the hand down. You got to get down. Calm down. So you need to move your feet. The sweat from the heat. Back to the back. Up, dog. And push back down, down. Jump the feet up to the hands. Chair pause. Arms up, legs bent. Dip trip, the Fantasia. Yeah! We're not really dancing yet. Hands down, straighten the legs. Lift the head and jump back. Bring it down, exhaling as you go. Inhale and arch up. Exhale and push back. Downward dog. Jump to the jam, boogie woogie jam. Everybody here? Anybody here? Right leg up in the air. Push the left heel down toward the floor. From here, swing the foot up to the hands. Come into the crescent pose. Back leg as straight as you can get it. Front leg is bent pretty much right angle. Arms are straight. Either straight up like that, or you can bring the hands together with the index finger up. You can still groove while you're here. All right, bring the hands down to the floor. Step the foot back. Come down. Arch up. And push back. Down dog. Yeah. Left leg up in the air. Push the right heel down. Okay, swing the foot up. Crescent pose. If it's too intense, bend the right leg a little bit. If you need more, drop the head back and arch back. You don't need anything, just hang out and dance. Unlike what you're doing now. All right, bring the hands down to the floor. Step the foot back. Come down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, downward dog. Now just for fun, we're gonna jump the feet. Don't do it yet. Jump the feet up to the hands, barely touch them, and then jump them right back. All right, so. Jump them up, jump them right back. Come on down. Arch up. That was funny. Push back, down dog. One more time. Jump them up and back. Arch up. Push back, down dog. 20 more times. Just stay here, sinking the chest down. Jump the feet up to the hands. Chair pause. Up with the arms high as you can get them. And bring the hands to the floor, straighten the legs. Just hang here, relax for a moment. It won't last, but enjoy it while it does. Inhale. We'll be back in a moment. Stay tuned. You're watching Oxygen Media. And we are back, and it's a good thing. Roll all the way up, stretch up. Arch back a little bit. Exhale, come forward. Lift the head, jump back. Come down.
Where are you going?
And arch up. Push back, down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up. Crescent pose. Turn the back foot, the left foot flat down. Turn to the side into a warrior pose. Gonna lift the chest a little bit. It looks so easy, we should just hold it until it doesn't look so easy. Slide the left hand down the back leg, reach back with the right arm, turn the right palm down toward the floor, kind of roll the right shoulder open, ribs open, look up. Bring the right hand down to the floor, flat down on the floor, left arm straight up in the air. You can bring the hand down to the outside or inside of the foot, whatever you like better. Keep rolling the left ribs, shoulder and chest open as you look up. Make sure the right leg is bent. And reach underneath the front leg with the right arm. Grab the left hand or wrist behind your back if you can. Sense of desperation is filling the stage. Bring the hands down to the floor. Step the foot back. Come down. And up, up dog. Push back, downward dog. Left leg up in the air. Swing it up. Crescent pose.
No matter what the price is, it keeps the spirit lively. Just as you're feeling blue, we'll all be there for you.
And turn the right foot down this time. Other side. Warrior.
All we have.
Longer, do you think? My watch has stopped. All right, slide the hand down the back leg, reach back. Good enough. Bring the hand down, left hand down, flat down if you can. Put some weight on it. Uh-oh. Right arm straight up in the air. Feel free to improvise. Keep rolling the right ribs open. Very serious. Reach underneath the front leg. Grab the right fingers or hand or wrist behind you. Roll the shoulder and chest open. Look up. Somebody doesn't smile soon, we're gonna hold it. We'll take it. Bring the hands down. Step it back. Stay up in the top of the push-up. Okay, come on down at your own speed, which is usually lightning fast. Once you're there, arch up. And push back down. We're feeling good now. Right leg up in the air. Good enough to do more. Yeah. Swing the foot up. Crescent pose. Nice and easy. Hook the left elbow over the front leg into a prayer style twist. Or you can bring the left hand to the floor, right arm up in the air if you like that better. But straighten the back leg, in this case the left leg, as much as you can. Roll the right chest open. Try to point, if you're doing the prayer style, point the right elbow straight up. And then look up and breathe. Oh, baby. Love and happiness. Love and happiness. And come down with the hands. Step the foot back. Come on down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Jump both feet up to the hands. Uh-oh, jump them right back. What happened? Come down. Arch up. This is the warm-up section after all. Push back, down dog. You don't look warm to me. Left leg up in the air.
I'll be good to you. We'll be together.
Swing it up. Crescent pose.
Walk away with victory.
Slowly come into the twist, hook the elbow into the prayer style if you can. Or the other style is also appropriate. If you're doing the one hand down and one arm up, really push down hard with the right hand, extend up with the left fingertips like you are doing. Okay, hands down, step it back, sink down, arch up, stay here, that's enough, push back, down dog, and step or jump the feet up to the hands, and just hang down there, legs are straight. You can kind of grab the ankles if you want and pull the forehead in toward the shins. But at least hang there. We'll do more warm-up when we return. Stay here. Stay tuned to Inhale. Oh, yeah. And we're back. Roll all the way up. Stretch up. Exhale, come all the way forward. Slow motion, apparently. Hands down, head up, jump back. Come down. Arch up. And push back, down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Since you're gonna be this way, two can play that game. Keep the right leg just where it is. Raise the left hand off the floor. Either out in front of you, out to the side, or behind your back. Just do the best you can. Just remember, if you fall, it's going to look bad. Just do the best you can. Fake it if necessary. you fall, they're going to put your name right under the picture of it. And come down with the leg and hand. Try the other side. Left leg up in the air. Maybe this side will be luckier for you. Right hand off the floor, either in front of you, to the side, or behind your back. Whatever works best for you. If it doesn't work at all, that's okay. Just fake it. And bring it down. Jump both feet up to the hands. Chair pose would be good right about now. Come on up. Okay, bring the hands down, legs straight. Lift the head, jump back or step back. Come down. Arch up. And push back, down, dog. Right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up to the hands. Turn the back foot, the left foot flat down. Hands interlocked behind you. Pull the shoulders back. Bring the head down toward the floor, close as you can. Make sure the back foot is very flat. If for some strange reason you don't feel anything, slide the foot back, the back foot, back a little bit further. And bring the hands to the floor, step the foot back. That hurts. Come on down. Maybe. Arch up. Push back, down dog. I've never seen you guys so quiet, ever. Exactly. Left leg up in the air. And swing the foot up. Other side, same thing. Turn the right foot flat this time. Hands behind you, come down. Make it beautiful. Okay, hands down. Step it back. Bring it down. Exhaling as you go. Inhale and arch up. Stay here. Pull the shoulders back and down a little bit. And push back into the down dog. Jump the feet up to the hands. Sit down. Turn this way. Let's do this one. Ready. The hands are about a foot behind you, fingers pointing toward the feet. Try to push the feet flat. Hips up, chest up, head back. If you can't flatten the feet, don't worry about it. If it's too hard, you can bend the knees like that. That makes it a little easier. Or sitting down makes it a lot easier. Don't come down yet. Don't come down yet. All right, sit down. Turn the other way. Hands down, jump the feet back. And arch up. And push back, down dog. Ouch. That's not an ouch. Right leg up in the air. This will be an ouch, though. shuffle it up. Turn the back foot flat, straighten the front leg. Bring the left hand to the floor, right arm up in the air, and do a twisting triangle as much as you can. Roll the right shoulder and chest open as you look up toward the right fingertips or ceiling. Breathe. If you're okay here and this is easy, you can bring the left hand to the outside of the right foot. If it's too intense for you, even with the hand to the inside of the foot, you can always get a little block or an object or something. Rest the hand on it that way, or you can bring it to the shin. That works. And then bring the right hand down, but otherwise stay where you are. Kind of sink the chest down toward the knee. And step the foot back. Come down. Arch up. And push back, downward dog. Left leg up in the air. Swing it up. Turn the back foot down. Keep the right hand down this time. Left arm up as much as you can. Roll open into the twist. Both legs are straight. Bring the hand to the floor. Stay there. Lean out over that front leg. And set the foot back. Come on down. Arch up. And push back, downward dog. Stay here. Breathe. Jump the feet up to the hands. Why not? Chair pose. Don't answer. Not a real question. Okay, bring the hands down, straighten the legs. From here, roll all the way up, stretch up, arch back a little bit. And exhale, come all the way forward. Step the feet apart about hip distance and just hang down. If you want, you can grab the big toes with the fingers and pull down. But stay hanging forward this way. We'll be right back. Stay tuned. Stay tuned to Oxygen Media. And we're back. We're going to do a little triangle pose. Make sure the feet are wide apart. Turn the left foot all the way out. Bring the arms up. Inhale deep as you exhale. Extend out. Come down. Keep both legs very straight, strong. If you want a little more stretch on the waist and ribs, bring this arm straight over your head. Breathe while you're here. Make sure you're rolling the right ribs back. Try to bring the upper body in alignment with the legs. Okay? And slowly, come on up. Other side. Turn the right foot out this time. Arms up. Come on down. And slowly, come on up. Turn the feet straight. Step the feet together. Sit down. Once you're down, keep the left leg straight out in front of you. Bend the right leg like this. Or, if you want, you can bring it back like that for a change of pace. Either one's okay. Once you're there, the arms come up. And then you come down over the straight leg as far as you want to. Ideally, you would extend the heel of the left leg, pushing the back of the knee down, pulling the top of the foot. But it's not an ideal world for many people. So if this is too intense for you, you can just grab a hold of the shin and come down that way. You don't have to come all the way down, or you can get a towel or a strap and come up that way. A lot of ways to work it. But whatever you do, breathe and relax. Come on up. Other side, same thing. Either the leg is bent like so, or you can bring it back. Either one. Whichever one you like best. Inhale the arms up, and then exhale out and down. If your flexibility allows, you can do what Alana is doing, full splits. You just take that back leg all the way back straight. But if Andrew tries it, he will be hospitalized for a nice long time. It could be beneficial for him, you never know. Get him out of circulation a little. Stay here, breathe. There was once this great yogi who I was fortunate enough to spend some time with. He was asked the difference between psychology and yoga. And he said, psychology is based on suffering. Yoga is based on bliss. That is the difference, my friend. Which I think is good. So if you're not blissful in this pose, you must have a psychological model that you're seeing things through. All right, come on up. Bring the soles of the feet together. Pull them way in. Grab a hold, extend out, initially with a straight spine. And then eventually you can let the spine round, come down low as you can. Thank you. It's all right. If this hurts or doesn't look like you think it should, doesn't matter. Don't be discouraged. Everybody's built a little bit differently. Eventually it'll open up. I read somewhere that in the USSR they used to x-ray the girls they were going to make gymnasts. They would x-ray their hips and they could tell by the bones if they were going to be a gymnast or not. So they would just look at the x-rays and say, no, 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 yes. Because everybody's built different. So some people, when their legs are completely wide out like this, the bones aren't touching and you have more flexibility. I used to do this to the point where my legs would start to go back that way, which is a little scary, so I stopped. But some people, they get here and bone hits bone. That means it can't go any farther. So it's not a matter of flexibility, it's a matter of how you're built. So everybody's built a little bit differently. Whether your hips are internally rotated or externally rotated, there's a whole elaborate science behind it. So the main thing is just don't take it too seriously. Hang out. The more you just relax in it and let go of any goal orientation, the better for you. Hard for Americans to do, nonetheless, that's real yoga. Okay, come on up. But I'll just assume that you guys have plenty of flexibility and we'll do the pigeon. Maybe because it's French, it'll be easier for you. The pigeon, come down. Right down over that front leg. What happens if this knee comes out here? Okay? Right. Try to pull the knee out to the side a little bit. You can always pull the front foot up a little higher. We're not going to hold this very long. We're just going to get a little stretch. So sink into it deep. And there's a million variations on all these poses. For example, this one, you could come up here, and then you can grab the back leg and pull in, which will stretch the quad or the top of the thigh. That hurts. If you do a lot of running or anything like that, this will stop you.
Okay, come on up.
Other side, same thing. Doesn't matter what side you're doing, as long as you're doing the other side now. Just stay here. We'll come back and do a little relaxation. On inhale, stay with us. You're watching Inhale. And we're back. We're going to do a little deep relaxation. So you're on your back, palms are turned up, face is relaxed. If you need to shift around a little bit to get comfortable, go ahead. Now's the time. And take a very long, slow breath all the way to the top of the lungs. Hold it for a moment. And let it go. One more time. Long, deep breath. And just let it go. And just melt into the floor. If you look at your body with the mind's eye, you can't really tell. There's no sharply defined edges. You can't tell where the body stops and the space surrounding it begins. So see if you can just kind of expand outward. So you can't really tell if you have a form at all. If you don't dip back into the memory and you go only by present evidence with the eyes closed, can you really say you have any form? Sensations or perceptions of the outside world, music, sounds, touch, taste, but all this is occurring in the infinite space that you are. So you're not bound by them. They're like little tiny bubbles in a vast ocean. You're absolutely free and open. That's the feeling. Start to come back a little bit. Take a long, deep breath. Again, but slow, gentle. Let it go. And roll very slowly onto your right side. And from here, come up into a sitting position. Eyes remain closed. Just sit just for a few seconds, maintaining the same feeling, just remaining open, spacious, without boundaries, without limits, without suffering. Bring the palms together, and we say, Namaste.